Well, after Chobani filed a lawsuit against a right-wing radio host, Alex Jones originally said he would fight the suit. Yesterday, he changed his tune. Kelsey Soto joins us now live in the studio to talk about the effects of those claims. Kelsey.
While many appreciate the apology and hope it's a learning moment for people who make false claims, often the damage of public perception is already done.
Some of the claims that people make, it's not true.
Radio host Alex Jones publicly apologized on his show Wednesday, explaining that his statements about Twin Falls were untrue, an announcement that surprised many.
I actually commend him to come out and apologize, to come out and admit that everything he claimed is wrong.
For some, the apology has no influence.
It doesn't change what I do and how I feel personally about what's happening in our community and the people that are here and being resettled here.
Those inflammatory statements come after a year of attacks on Twin Falls from media publications all across the country.
I'm saddened to think that people will jump on the bandwagon and listen to and believe and follow such information that is often inaccurate.
Many of those publications with agendas of their own.
Their goal is to divide our community.
A lot of the stories stem from organizations thousands of miles from Twin Falls, leaving dangerous impressions in their wake.
Do a little research, ask questions, educate yourselves before making a judgment on what's happening in an area that you're not familiar with.
And asking someone who lives in Twin Falls those questions might get you some answers, or at least hearing information right from the source.
We shouldn't accept that people from outside our community tell our stories, tell who we are.
Zaze hopes this apology will spur others to admit that their information is wrong. He welcomes anyone with additional questions to visit the Refugee Center and ask them yourself.